Welcome, dear students, and here in today's session we are going to learn my childhood. You know, my childhood means whose childhood do you think, dear students? Can you say something?
APJ Abdul Kalam.
APJ Abdul Kalam.
Oh, great! Very good. You have watched the video, you have listened to the text, and also have read it many a time. And so you know that my childhood is of none but our former president, the great scientist, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, and you know, as he was one of the great personalities in India, today, students, there is a birth anniversary of such great personality in India. Can you please name them? Hello, dear students. Oh, Kushal More mentioned that Gandhiji. And one more person. His birth anniversary is also there today. Who is he?
Sir.
Yes. Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Bharat Ratna se, and also Gayatri Kurte, or Lal Bahadur Shastri. Hey, Arya, this is Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel or Lal Bahadur Shastri, you mean to say? Gayatri has answered correctly. So who are those great personalities? Mahatma Gandhi, the father of nation, he is called and known as, and also Mahatma. And then another person is Lal Bahadur Shastri. So would you like to read some more details about them briefly? Just for, you know, as we are observing Mahatma Gandhi's 150 years have been passed, that he was born on 2nd October 1869. Okay? I would like Vaishnavi Sharma to read a brief account about Mahatma Gandhi given to the right hand side of the screen. That is there. You can. Vaishnavi Sharma, please. Or Akanksha. Okay, Akanksha has just joined. Akanksha, would you like to read a brief account or the profile of Mahatma Gandhi? That is there on the screen, shared with you. Can you please, Akanksha?
Yes, sir.
You please read a brief account about, you know, Mahatma Gandhi. Today it is 2nd October, and you know it is declared as a national holiday all over India. You know why? Just to observe Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary. And 150 years have passed. So just please do some brief account about him. Can you see his picture? Studio photograph of Gandhi. 1921.
Yes, sir.
Just below that, the information given, you please read it. Full name?
Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi.
Born on?
2 October 1869.
Where?
In Porbandar. Kathiawar Agency, yes. Bombay Presidency, British India.
That time, right? That time.
Yes.
But today, in which state is that place?
Gujarat.
Yes, very good. Continue. Died on?
30 January 1948. Age 78. New Delhi, where? India.
How it happened? It was a natural death or an assassination?
It was due to the assassination.
It was gunshot wound. Who did that? Who was that fellow? Nathuram Godse. Who was he?
Yes, sir.
Nathuram Godse. He was the person who assassinated him with a gunshot. Right?
Yes, sir.
Then Where is his monument?
Rajghat, Gandhi Smriti.
And Gandhi Smriti. Yes. And what are other names that he is known as?
Mahatma Gandhi, Bapuji, Gandhiji, M.K. Gandhi.
So, what do you mean by Mahatma?
Mahatma means great.
Great soul. Mahatma. Maha means great and Atma soul. The great soul is Mahatma. Okay? Then, welcome Vaishnavi. We were missing you a lot. Welcome dear. Okay. Akansha, you continue.
Their citizenship is Indian.
Very good. Where did he study?
In the University College.
Good. What was his occupation?
A lawyer, politician, activist, and writer.
Good. During which year he was active? He was activist or in many things?
1893 to
1948. Yes, that was era known as British Raj.
British Raj.
And what is he known for?
Indian independence movement and non-violent resistance.
Very good. And what is his notable work as far as literature is concerned?
The story of my experiments with truth.
This is an autobiography, right? What difference do you find between biography and autobiography?
Yes, sir.
What is the difference between biography and an autobiography?
Biography is written by another person about a person's story, and autobiography is the person writing their own story.
About himself or herself. Very good. So, where is his office?
In the president of the Indian National Congress.
Good. What was the term that you were working during?
1924 to 1925.
In the political party or?
Indian National Congress.
Good. What are the movements that he participated in?
Indian independence movements.
Good. And what is his spouse's name?
Kasturba Gandhi.
Good. When did he marry with her? Marry her?
In 1883.
Yes. And when did she die?
1944.
Good. What are their? Who are their children?
Harilal, Manilal, Ramdas, Devdas.
Yes, two Lal and two Das. Who are Lal? Harilal, Manilal. And who are the Das?
Ramdas,
Devdas. Okay, good. Do you think they are all boys or girls? Means sons or daughters? What do you understand from their name? Very good. And who are the parents of Mahatma Gandhi?
Karamchand Gandhi was their father and Putlibai Gandhi was their mother.
Putlibai Gandhi, mother, and Karamchand Gandhi was his
their
father. Very good. Thank you, Akansha. Thank
Welcome,
you so much,
sir.
I will also share with you a link of a movie that is completely based on Mahatma Gandhi. Please watch it. If possible, after the session gets over, right? And here is another person, the great personality whose birth anniversary is being observed today. And I would like Arya Khurde to read about him.
Yes, sir.
Are you there? Yes, please. Who is he?
He was the second Prime Minister of India.
Name dear, what is his name?
Lal Bahadur Shastri.
But you mentioned Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel.
Sir, it was a mistake.
Okay, good boy. You are a human and that's what you did. Okay, please continue reading his information.
Sir, in the box or in the paragraph?
Box.
Sir, he was the second Prime Minister of India. In office 9 June 1964 to 11 January 1955.
Aryan, if you are the second Prime Minister of India, who was the first?
Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru.
Very good. And at the time you were second Prime Minister of India, who was the president?
Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan.
Good. And who was a Prime Minister, or sorry, President, you know, preceded by and succeeded by, who were they?
Preceded by
Gulzarilal Nanda, and
yes,
succeeded by
Gulzarilal Nanda,
good. Then he was also the Minister of External Affairs between 9th of June 1964 to 18th of June 1964. Right? And that time he was the Prime Minister, and preceded by Gulzarilal Nanda and succeeded by Indira Gandhi.
Indira Gandhi.
You know, Gulzarilal Nanda was an acting. So, they are not considered as second president or second Prime Minister. He is not considered. He was just an acting. Right?
Good. Yes, sir.
Then about his personal details, we will go in detail. What is his full name?
Lal Bahadur Shastri.
Lal Bahadur Srivastava. What is it?
Yes, sir. Lal Bahadur Srivastava.
Yes. And later he was known as Lal Bahadur Shastri.
Shastri.
When was he born?
2 October 1904.
Where?
Mughal Sahari, United Provinces of Agra and Aundh, British India. Now in Uttar Pradesh, India.
Very good. When did he die?
11 January 1956. Sir, that is 56 or 66?
1966.
At the age of 61.
Right. Where is his monument?
Vijay Ghat.
Good. What is the name of his spouse, wife?
So it is blur. Lalit Shastri.
And how many children did he have? Lal Bahadur Shastri's parents, Sharda Prasad Srivastava, father, and Ram Dulari Devi, mother. And he studied at Gandhi Kashi Vidyapeeth, and also he was awarded with Bharat Ratna in 1966. Okay, we should know the great personalities and some details about them. Fine. And like these two personalities' birth anniversary we are observing today, there is another personality whom you wrong.
Yes, sir.
And here they must have seen him being here in our foundation. Do we have auditory and hearing students in our campus?
Yes, sir.
What is the name?
Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Auditorium.
Good. What is it named after? Whose name?
Sir, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam.
Absolutely, the great scientist and also the President of India. Do you know that he had been here twice in our foundation?
Yes, sir.
But yes, sir.
Yes, that time you must be either in second or third class. Very young. I don't remember, but after that or before that also one he had been here. In 2015 and in 2005. In 2005, some of you might not have been born. That time he had been. Okay. How do I know? Was I there that time? No. But when I had been there in our auditorium, there are these details given. Have you ever read them? His photographs and all? You should be a keen observer. Wherever you go, you should be, you know, curious to know more about it. You know, the information provided. It doesn't take much time. Just in a single glance, you can read and remember those things longer. By the way, so this is about our president and the great scientist, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Can you name his autobiography? Someone said, right. You please repeat.
Sir, it's breaking.
Oh, I see. Am I audible now, Uzzal?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, what is the name of his autobiography? Kushal, you are saying right, but be closer to your mic here. Your voice is so low. Say louder.
Wings of Fire.
Yes. Wings of Fire. Wings of Fire. What is this name related to? Wings of Fire means there are wings made out of fire? Yes. And what was he known as?
The Missile Man of India.
Absolutely, very good. Would you like to read about Dr. Kalam, like you read about Mahatma Gandhi and also Lal Bahadur Shastri? Do you want to know about him?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good boy. This is Pratham Khandelwal. Pratham, you please read the details about him being shared with you on screen. Can you see it now? Pratham?
Yes, sir.
Can you see it on your screen?
Yes,
Dr.
sir.
Dr. Kalam's photograph and some information. You please read it.
Yes, sir.
So that everybody can listen.
11th President of India in office, 25th July 2002 to 25th July 2007. Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Manmohan Singh. Vice
yes,
President.
During or while he was President of India, there were two Prime Ministers. Firstly, he was Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and after that, Manmohan Singh. During his tenure of work only, right? Good.
Vice President.
Before him, P.R. Narayan was the president, and after him, Prati Patil, the first women president in India, was the president, right? Okay, now let's read about him, some personal details.
Yes, sir. Sir, he was born in Avul Pakir Jainuladdin Abdul Kalam.
He was born. His name is Aul Pakir. A for Aul. We say APJ Abdul Kalam. So A for Aul. Also pronounced as Abul. P for Pakir. J for Jainuladdin. And you know Abdul Kalam. So this is APJ Abdul Kalam. So his full name was Aul Pakir Jainuladdin Abdul Kalam. Was born on
15th October 1931, Ramesh.
Yes, in this month only. Today is 2nd October, and just after 13 days, his birth anniversary will be there. that he was born on 15th October 1931. Dear students, do you know what is this day, 15th October, observed as? Dear students, do you know what is this day observed as? His birthday in Maharashtra especially. Last year we had celebrated it with great enthusiasm. In library you had come across
yes,
the photographs on the wall and many posters inside and outside also. So when I say it was about library, then what do you understand? Even the photographs were great. What do you understand that day is observed in Maharashtra especially as? What is library for?
World Food Day.
Huh?
Reading.
Reading. What is library for? Reading books. And that is the day observed as Reading Day. What's it? Reading Day.
Reading
right?
Day.
Please remember. Good. Please continue. You are born on 15th October. Where are you?
Sir, Rameshwaram, Madras Presidency, British India.
And present day, what is it? In which state?
Present day, Tamil Nadu, in India.
Yes, good boy. And he died?
27 July 2015, aged 83.
Yeah.
In Shillong, Meghalaya, India.
Yes, I think in 2015, you must be remembering it well, that he was teaching children. His lecture was on, and that time it happened that he fell down and finally died. So till the last moment, you know, as we remember and also observe 14 November. Whose birthday, dear students, 14 November?
Pandit Jawaharlal.
Yes, and we observe it as
Children's Day.
Yes, the same way Dr. Kalam was also very fond of children. Right? And he spent all his life for children, teaching them, motivating them. Okay, let's continue.
Yes, sir. Rest in place, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Desia Naini Begum, Pei Karumlu. Sir, his nationality was Indian.
Yes.
And alma mater. Sir, what is meaning of alma mater?
Where you studied?
Sir,
the
I St. Joseph's College, Tiruchirappalli, Madras Institute of...
Good, good. So what was his profession? What was the profession?
Office scientist and author.
Very good. This is, I think, Nirmal. Very good, Nirmal.
Sir, his awards was full list?
No, there are many awards, you know. Yes. The full list, it will take much time to read. You know, we will not read all, but just notable work you can read. Pratham, you please read here some notable work. The book he has written.
Works, ignited minds, inotable spirit, transcendence.
Wings of Fire. Wings of Fire, an autobiography. India 2020. Ignited mind, indomitable spirit, transcendence, my spiritual experiences with Pramukh Swamiji. And there are so many such books he has written. And you know, there were the fields that he worked in was aerospace engineering, and the institutions he worked for were or worked with is DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization, and also ISRO, that is ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization. So it was a brief account and introduction about Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Did it help your students to know more about him? And then we are going to study his childhood. That's my childhood. And this is an extract from his autobiography. What's it, Nirmal? Wings of Fire. Right?
Sir, there is a
shared with you all. Did you watch it? Can you hear me now, dear students?
Yes, sir. Hello.
I hope your students, everything is right, all right. Are you able
yes,
to hear
sir,
me?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. So, what is this text adapted from? His autobiography, The Wings of Fire. Okay. Let's now come to the topic directly, without wasting time. That is page number 68. Good. Thank you. So please turn over the page and be there on page number 68. I'm also sharing with you the screen. Before you read, this is unit number 6, my childhood from our textbook in English for class 9, behind. So, first activity that we will do here is about scientists and also in a statement. The question is, can you think of any scientist who have also been a statement? Can you answer your students? Can you think of any scientist who have also been statesmen? Yes or no? Say something. Everybody is quiet. One example you know, yes, sir. That is also enough.
Sir, what is the meaning of statesman?
Means those who contributed in the development of the nation, being in a politics or a day. That is statesman.
Sir, APJ Abdul Kalam.
Yes, very good. And another example, not from India, but you can say from USA, United States of America, Thomas Jefferson. You know, who has been the founding fathers, but who was also an accomplished scientist in his own right. So those who have been scientists also and that contributed. And we know the previous lesson we have studied. What was it about? Who was also a great scientist? Who wrote a letter to the president, but received no response. And later, when the World War took place, and the Nagasaki and the Hiroshima, the cities from Japan. Yes, very good question. Absolutely, absolutely. You know that the latter contributed and involved himself in the politics and did a lot for the welfare of the people in the world. Nirmal, if you are saying nothing, you please unmute yourself, or may I unmute you? Don't worry. Fine. So you got the first activity, dear students, about the scientist who had also been a statesman.
Yes, sir.
In today's gender sensitivity, we can say statesperson. We used to say gentleman, it became gentleperson. No, this is now man, woman, as a difference with a person. Chairman has been now chairperson. This is gender sensitivity. Second, APJ Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space, you know that he was also known as Missile Man, defense and nuclear technology guided India into the 24th century, became our 11th president in 2002. You know that we have read about him. Now, the third point is in his autobiography, what is Wings of Fire? It speaks of his childhood. So would you like to know, dear students, what Kalam used to do when he was just similar in age of you all? Would you like to know more about him? Very good. I think the video you have watched, do you want me to play it again? I think no use. You have watched it again. And again, because the link was shared with you all on WhatsApp group. So let's directly start with the paragraph number 1 on page number 68. Akanksha, would you like to read it?
Yes, sir.
Please.
I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. My father, Jainulabdin, had neither formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, far more outsiders ate with us than all the own family put together. I was
right. Well, yes, okay. Thank you, Akanksha. And there now he is telling about his family. And what does he say? That he was born in a middle class Tamil family, not so poor nor rich. And what was the place? It was Rameshwaram. The town, Rameshwaram. And erstwhile, previously it was known as Madras Presidency, or Madras State. What is the present name of Madras?
Chennai.
Yes, absolutely. And his father's name is Jainulabdin, who had not completed his formal education and not he was wealthy, not he had enough money. But despite this thing, even though he was not educated and not so rich, you know, there was something that he possessed. And what was it? Great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. And innate, you can say, inborn, right from his birth, without being trained and educated, because his innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit and his helpmate, another half we can say of his family, or Eshiyama, Dr. Kalam's mother, who always cooperated her, and both of them, you know, were doing well for their family. But was it only of their family? No. He was the one, you know, who was feeding the people more than total family members in their family. And that way we can say that he was really a generous person and helping others. Welcome, Ghanshyam. Very great to hear. So for Ghanshyam, who would like to tell some details about Dr. Kalam? Yes, students, whenever you are reading in the text, you please highlight the keywords. They will help you definitely to just glance through at the time of revision, when you have short of time, but you want to study everything. So what are the keywords? I am telling you keywords, and based on those keywords, you please tell me everything that is there in this para number one. The keyword is middle class Tamil family, Rameshwaram, Jainulating, formal education, wealth, innate, generosity, Eshiyama, faith, outsiders, family members. These are the keywords. Now, based on this keyword, can you please elaborate everything that is there in this para number one? Anyone, spontaneously. Yogiraj, can you hear?
Sir, page number
68. Anyone please share? I have told you the keywords now. You please tell what is there.
He was born into a middle class Tamil family in Rameshwaram. His father's name was Jainulabdin, and he had not much formal education and nor wealth also, but he was innate wisdom and a true generous person. He helped his mother Ashiyamma, and her mother fed many people outside us.
Okay, good. Am I audible now, everyone? Nirmal, did you try to tell what is it about? I wish more also tried well. Okay, I'm telling. So when you say Tamil family, you should understand that you were born in Tamil family. We have another keyword, Rameshwara. Who was his father? Jainulabdin. That highlighted word. How was he not educated, not having much wealth. But another keyword, innate, that he possessed great innate wisdom, and another keyword was true generosity of spirit. Then another next keyword was Eshiyamma. We can understand that he was his mother. Then the next keyword was faith, that she used to feed the people more than total in her family. So that's what we have learned about Dr. Kalam and his childhood. Ghanshyam, did you understand? Briefly, I have told you. Dear Ghanshyam, did you understand here? You joined us late. Are you there or not? Are you again left? I think he has left again. By the way. Any question, dear students? You understood the first para about his childhood, his family?
Yes.
Especially only about his mother and father. Now let's see about other family members and his friends also. Would you like to know? Let's see, second para. And here is Rajnandini reading the second para. Rajnandini, please.
Yes, sir. I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks, born to talk and handsome parents, with we live in our ancestral house, which was built in the middle of the 19th century. It was a fairly large pukka house made of limestone and bricks on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram.
Mosque, dear, mosque. As Hindus have temple, Muslim people have their mosque.
Street in the Rameshwaram. My austere father used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. However,
necessities. Means the things that are required. They are necessities. For example, pain is a necessity, but I want the pain costing more than 1,000. Is that necessity? No.
No.
But we can say a luxury. Yes.
However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine, or clothes. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, but mature materially and emotionally.
Very good. Thank you. You can do it yourself. So here now he is telling about himself and his family. He told us about his father and mother. Okay. But now, as far as his son, he was a very short boy. You know, his parents were taller, but he was very short. And today, you know, as you know that birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri, he was also a very short person. But his work spoke louder. And he made himself, you know, lasting longer in politics. And also, we remember him after his death also. So, such a short boy, being Dr. H.P.J. Abdul Kalam, you know, how big personality he is, you know, today. But people that time found him a very short boy, born in the family, having parents, very taller, and very handsome. So they were living in the ancestral house, where his grandparents were living and other ancestors. They were also living in the same house. And that way, his family was living in that, you know, because of the 19th, the houses were built out of some limestone and also stones. And so the family, this way, was living in such a fairly large pakka house that was made up of not only the limestone, but also the bricks were also there. And where was it located? On the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. Now he again comes telling us about his father. And his father was austere, very simple, strict and severe. How? He was not providing any unessential comforts or luxuries. He used to avoid them all because he knew that the luxuries and the comforts will make the person lazy. And where we have only the needs fulfilled, we definitely will work in order to meet our needs, and also will definitely work harder in order to meet them throughout our life. And that's why he has been mentioned as an Oster father. It means simple, strict, and severe. Simple means simple living but high thinking. Strict, he used to provide everything, but he wanted discipline maintained in the family and also everywhere. Severe, if you are not doing well and if you are found that you have been lazy and not doing your work that you are supposed to do, then taking some action. That way he was severe. Right? Understood, dear students, about his house, about his height and all, and also the parents he had. What is your student? You can respond. Are you getting it?
Yes,
well? That how his family is, who are his parents, how are they, and why he finally says that. I will take you back to the previous page and last para, that he says in the last sentence. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally. How? Materially and emotionally. He says his childhood was very secure. What do you understand from this? Please elaborate. Such kinds of questions will be asked in the examination under question number 6 and 7 for 5 marks each. What's it? What do you understand from this statement that he says his childhood was very secure, both materially and emotionally? Please explain your students. Then only I can say that you have understood the meaning between the lines provided here on page number 68. That is understanding, that is comprehension. Otherwise, you will just be able to read it and understand. That is not enough. Then what are teachers for? Come on, you please try. I'm going to tell you, but you please try yourself first. No answers? Nobody? So simple, dear. I'm telling you some hints, but I want you to explain me later. And we will end this session with this only. Okay? So, materially, this material thing. Clothes, food, and some, for example, textbooks and everything that is provided. So that means he was secure. His childhood was secure from material things point of view. He was provided everything. He said now that all the necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine, or clothes. That is material. These are material things. And so he was secure. He had not to ask for these things to anybody else. His parents were there to provide and always ready with those things to be given to the students, to the children. And so he says his childhood was secure materially. Now emotionally, dear students, emotionally. You know, if a child is not loved by the parents and is not loving the parents, then he tries to find love outside of the family, and it creates the problem. So in such family, we can't say that this childhood was emotionally secular. But when a child realizes that I am being loved by my parents, even if they are strict, even if they are getting angry sometimes, but they love me, they realize. And you know, they also find complete freedom to share themselves with the parents. That is emotional freedom. And that was given, that was there with Dr. Kalam. He could share everything with his mother, he could share everything with his father. And he could seek help, he could seek guidance from both of them. And this way, we know dear students that Dr. Kalam's childhood was emotionally secure. What about you? Is your childhood secure materially? Yes, of course. That is the reason that you are studying in such a school. What about emotionally? It must be secure, dear students. It's up to you how you secure it, how you make it secure emotionally. If you are not sharing everything with your parents, if you are not sharing everything with your elders, the teachers, about whatever the problems you are facing about, then it is not secure. It is insecure. But you please make it secure, always, emotionally. You should be always free to share everything, your emotions. You should be able to express them, being very honest and true with yourself and also with your parents. Right, dear students? Do you agree with me? Vaishnavi, Sudhi, Shreyash, Kaili, Sanskruti, many of you are there. So again, I am leaving here with question and answer. You please let me know your views also later in the next session, that how is childhood and of course your secure, both materially and emotionally. Anyway, any doubts dear students, please let me know.
No sir.
No sir.
No sir.
Fine. Yes. That's it for today.
No,
thank you so much dear students. Have a great day ahead. Bye.
Thank you sir. Bye sir.
Bye sir.
Bye sir.
Bye sir.
Thank you sir. Bye sir.